Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy Nuke.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Now, let's just dig right into it. Errol Spence Jr. claims he's the truth. Claims that no one wants any smoke. Claims that he's the baddest motherfucker at welterweight. Now, let's just break this down. Because, you know, over the weekend, you had the Maurice Hooker-Alex Saucedo fight. And in that fight, you had Terence Bud Crawford meet Errol Spence Jr. after the fight. And fake, biased new media comes out and tries to change the narrative of the story from what they should be reporting on to what they want to be reporting on. And let me break this down for you. Let me give you an example. Now, you have Errol Spence Jr. They made the entire discussion about who pulled up on who. And I'm just going to give it to you unbiased, real, and raw. What fucking difference does it make who pulled up on who? What fucking difference does that make? It makes absolutely no difference. Only an idiot would think that makes a difference depending on who pulled up on who. This is what makes a difference, and let me break it down for you. The difference is when Terence Crawford said, "Fight me," Errol Spence Jr. said, "I'm taking the easy route. I'm fighting Mikey Garcia, Sean Porter, and Keith Thurman." No mention of Terence Bud Crawford, has no interest in fighting him. So even if he did pull up, even if you are correct, what difference does it make? He's admitted that he's taking the easy fucking route, and he wants absolutely no part of Terence Bud Crawford. Now, how many times did I tell you that he was ducking Terence Crawford? And everyone came out and say, "No, you're a fanboy. No, you hate Errol Spence Jr." And I keep telling you, I'm not biased, unbiased. The truth hurts. And this just proves, once again, you heard it from the horse's mouth. He wants no part of Terence Crawford. He named every opponent he could before he could name Terence Crawford. Biased new media wanted to change the narrative and make it about who pulled up on who. Let's be 100% honest and unbiased. He does not want to fight Terence Bud Crawford. He sees Terence Bud Crawford as a legitimate threat. And that basically, him coming to the Top Rank event was only for show. That's what it is. You can have people change a narrative. But I noticed a few other things about that. You know, I noticed when Terence Bud Crawford said, "You won't hit me with body shots." Errol Spence Jr. tried to ignore that point. I noticed another thing is when Terence Bud Crawford called him on his weight, his massive weight gain, basically saying, "You're not bigger than everybody, you're just fat," and prodded at him like a fucking animal. And, you know, Errol Spence Jr. insists, "Oh, I hit the hardest." That was his only response to anything Terence Crawford had, was, "Oh, I hit way harder. Ask this guy if I hit harder than you. Ask that guy if I hit harder than you." This lets me know that Errol Spence Jr. has the wrong mindset for a Terence Bud Crawford, because the Terence Bud Crawford fight and Errol Spence Jr. mega fight, should that happen, should he stop ducking Terence Crawford, that fight will not be contingent on who hits harder. It won't. That fight is only contingent on who has the most skill, because at some point skills will pay the bills. It's going to come down to skills in a fight, and Errol Spence Jr. only thought is to be the biggest, strongest, harding hitting guy. And at some point he'll realize being the most powerful guy will not be what wins these mega fights. You have to understand that Errol Spence Jr. is going to have to melt himself down to 147. He's basically not just a naturally bigger guy, he's fucking fat. He's overweight and he stays out of shape in between fights. He's not taking care of his body. He drains himself down to 147. This is what's going to cost him the fight with Mikey Garcia, because he's not in spectacular shape. This would cause you to question everything about an Errol Spence Jr. The fact that he's never fought an elite level opponent, the fact that his biggest win came off a guy with a knockout loss and it took him the distance, almost basically 10 fucking rounds. You look at an Errol Spence Jr. only worried about power in a matchup with Terence Crawford. That is very telling about who this guy is. He has nowhere to go but with power shots. And Terence Crawford is basically just going to pick him apart. And you wonder why he's avoiding Terence Crawford. And you wonder why Terence Crawford is so adamant about wanting this fight. Because the way the media, this fake biased new media, hypes up Errol Spence Jr., the way that every fanboy for Errol Spence comes out, and the only thing that they can say is, "Oh, but he hits hard. And, you know, I find it hilarious when people say, oh, but Errol Spence Jr. can box. He can box. Errol Spence Jr. cannot box. He's a very amateurish boxer. And to prove that, why didn't he mention his boxing abilities when he was sitting in front of Terence Bud Crawford? See, obviously, this was all for media's attention. This was all for show. Why didn't he mention how good he could box? Because he can't. He understands that his whole boxing game and career is based on how hard he can hit. That's it. Terence Crawford is not ducking Errol Spence. The whole welterweight division is not ducking Errol Spence. I understand that other welterweights are waiting to see what unfolds. But at the same time, the whole welterweight division is ducking Terence Crawford as well. You see Keith Thurman shying away from any of the big, you know, the big fights, the big matches. He want to go down a familiar road with Deshaun Porter, a guy who he felt he beat once and he felt he could beat easier the second time. They say it's always easier the second time for the boxer to beat the guy. So he wants absolutely no part of Terence Crawford. And you see Errol Spence admitted that he wants no part of Terence Crawford. When I tell you guys something, I'm giving it to you unbiased, and you have all these fanboys who come in the comment section, who approach me on social media, and who swear that I hate Errol Spence Jr. Let me clear this up. I do not hate Errol Spence Jr. I like Errol Spence Jr. He's a very entertaining fight. But my thing is, we have to expose who's not at the top level. We have to expose who's not elite. And we have to expose hype jobs. And Errol Spence Jr. is a hype job. Once again, giving it to you unbiased, real, and raw. IBFP.